Hello, I'm Theresa Skorseth with another edition of Church and State. We have two special guests here today. Winona Helmsly Billionaire is here. She happened to be in town and I ran into her and I said, oh, come to the studio. We want you for Church and State. So she said she'd be happy to do it. And this is Douglas Olson, a local pundit, an intelligent guy who knows a lot of stuff. So he's here to bring his perspective on Church and State issues. It's Lenten season for Christians. These are the weeks leading up to Good Friday and Easter Sunday, the day that Christ was crucified and the day that Christ rose from the dead. And so it's a holy season. Do you think it's acceptable that all through my childhood, let me back up a little, all through my childhood there was an Easter break. We called it Easter break from school. I think they call it spring break now so they don't have to acknowledge one religion over another. But do you think that it's acceptable that we are now calling it spring break and we're calling Christmas winter break and we're not invoking the old Christian traditions in our policies?
You know, neither word really offends me. You know, I'll refer to them interchangeably as Christmas break, winter break, Easter break, spring break. So, you know, neither one of them, you know, bothers me. I mean, you know, some people might, you know, take umbrage, you know, at calling, you know, Christmas break, winter break, or Easter break, spring break, or vice versa, you know. To me, I'm fine with either one.
People seem to feel very strongly about that. What about you, Winona?
Well, did you say today's date that we're actually...
Oh, yes, today, that's a good point, because this may not air until May. today is the 21st of March, so we are in the Lenten season at this point.
And I just want to point out, first of all, there we get to that politically correct stuff again. And, of course, I object to that politically correct talk because it's just not necessary. I think we should still call things for what they are. Easter break should be called Easter break because that's what it really is. But I have different views. I take my religious conviction really seriously, and I think this country was built on the Christian faith, and I think we should cling to those things that we have held so patriotic and honorable for such a long-standing time in our country.
Well, let's bring it down a little narrower. On Ash Wednesday, many Catholics of all ages go to confession. They receive a cross of ashes on their forehead by the priest to show that they've been there and that they are penitent. And should they have to wash that off as children before they go back to school? A, should they get the time off to go to confession during school hours? And B, should they come back with a cross on their forehead? Or is that equivalent to wearing a hijab for a Muslim girl?
That's a very good question. Why don't you go first?
Sure. And I haven't met you before, Winona. It's nice to meet you.
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting. We might disagree on a lot of stuff, but I hope we can disagree.
We probably will, from what I've heard about you.
Yeah, she knows that I'm active in the Brainerd Area Coalition for Peace, a local peace group, and you know, I encourage people watching this program to visit the BACP website. It's, again, Brainerd Area Coalition for Peace, www.brainerdpeace.org. As a matter of fact, we have a stretch of Highway 371 that we do some cleanup on every spring and fall. So you can see our sign says Brainerd Peace Coalition. So yeah, Brainerd Coalition for Peace is a bit of a mouthful sometimes. You know, some people just refer to it as Brainerd Peace Coalition. So if you type that in the internet, you know, Brainerd Peace Coalition, you'll get our website, which our webmaster, Richard Schiller, does an excellent job on. Dick keeps it up to date. It's very informative. Anything you'd ever want to know about our group, you'll find out. And it's interesting, we were talking about church and state because our group, we're not religious. You know, we're not affiliated with any particular religion or political party, but we do meet at the First Congregational Church, also known as the United Church of Christ, every first Monday of the month at 7 p.m. And the UCC is located near Gregory Park in Brainerd, 415 Juniper Street. And that information's on our website. We also have a very nice Facebook page that one of our members, Cody Robertson, does a great job on. So I just want to let people know about that. Anyways, back to your question. When I was going to school, sometimes you'd see that on Ash Wednesday where students, you know, would have the cross on their forehead. And that never offended me. You know, it doesn't bother me at all. They should be able to do that. And as far as giving them time off for that, sure. You know, just like when I was going to school, there was release time. You know, I didn't even know what that was at first until I found out it was, you know, give children time to go to church or something like that. Mm-hmm. And again, that doesn't bother me. You know, the thing that would bother me is, you know, school prayer as far as, you know, the teacher or a student, you know, saying, okay, let us pray, you know. I think the Supreme Court struck the right balance, and I think it was 1984 they made a decision where, you know, students, you know, can pray on their own. You know, there can be religious activities before or after school, you know, and that religious groups can meet on school grounds. But, you know, the school should never have, you know, prayers itself, you know, whether it's led by a principal, a teacher, or a student. You know, that